Hallelujah. I welcome everyone in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And once again, welcome to the Lake Church of Pentecost, UK. Shall we begin the service? I want everyone to join in even as we start with prayers. Can we be quiet? Because we started the service and join in the singing and then prayer as well. Shall we bow our heads? The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercy never comes to an end. Great shall we thank you for his faithfulness. Give you all the praise, Father. Oh, Father, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. Father, we thank you for the love bestowed on us. We thank you, Father, for your mercy. We thank you, Father, for the wonderful grace. You've been kind to us, Father. You've been kind to us. We thank you, Lord. We just want to say we love you, Father.
What is
the word
that
you call
it?
And what
would that
be for
you?
Because you first love us. Oh, we thank you for that.
Now, when the
money is in the world, I don't know. We thank you, Father. Today. We've gathered because of your purpose. We've gathered because of your grace. We've gathered, Father, because you've kept us. We can, Father, what to say? We can afford not to say thank you, Father. We can afford not to praise your Holy. We can afford, Father, not to appreciate the good. What shall I render? What shall I render? Oh, what shall I render to you? Oh, committed to this meeting unto God's hands. We know the Spirit of God is yet to take control of all the things that we're going to do today. We're going to commit everyone that will stand before God's people that God should speak through that person. We're going to pray that anyone that is in this world will not live the same, but that person will be touched, will be touched, will be touched, and will have a visitation from God. Shall we pray this very time? Father, it is that we can see what we see today. It is just by your grace that your church is enjoying all these things. And today we commit the service of your hands once again. We know that, Father, we will be blessed mightily. So at the end of the day, Father, we will give you glory for what you've done. We commit the whole thing unto your Lord. Take glory. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. God is good. All the time. Amen. On behalf of the chairman of today's meeting, I'd like to welcome everybody to this service. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. We want to acknowledge the presence of some of our guests here. And we are delighted to have with us in this service delegates from Europe, from the United States of America, and from within the United Kingdom as well. We have Pastor Emmanuel Chun, Pastor Emmanuel Chun, Mrs. Charlotte Chun, okay, and then Pastor Joseph Osborne Nate, Mrs. Nate. We have Pastor Timothy Pabifield. Alright. So we have Charlie and Teres. Can you stand? We want to acknowledge your presence. Eddie and Kathleen, are you here? Okay. Alright. Paul and Jennifer. Paul and Jennifer. Alright. Okay. Thank you. And Helen Ntonso, Mrs. Helen Ntonso, are you here? From Europe we have Elder Atta from Norway. Elder Atta from Norway. Thank you. Pastor Thomas Jose from Norway. Pastor Thomas Jose from Norway. Alright. We also have Pastor Dr. Francis Bonsu and Mrs. Gladys Bonsu. We have Pastor Frank Alper, Pastor Frank Alper, Mrs. Alper, Mrs. Alper, thank you. And we also have Pastor Francis Ajay from Italy. Thank you. We have Pastor Milton Fusen Yako from Greece. Mrs. Helen Yako. Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. We have Pastor Eben Ekwe. Ben Ekwe from Germany. Thank you for coming. We have our own Apostle Dr. Emmanuel Owusu. And Mrs. Patience Owusu from France. Thank you. Thank you for your presence. Thank you. And we also have our own Apostle Albert Amor, National Head of the Church of America. So I said, here with us. Okay. We shall introduce the others as a member. The other introductions I would like to give them to the chairman of the meeting to come. But on this note, we want to acknowledge the presence of the chairman of the meeting, our own International Missions Director, Apostle Dr. Stephen Bozi Bailey. Thank you. And all the Elim Church of Pentecost pastors are also here. We acknowledge your presence and the family members as well. And all of you, thanks for coming. And God bless you so much. So on this note, we ask the chairman of the meeting to come and say something to us. Shall we put our hands together for it?
Excellent.
morning. You know, the room is fully packed, so we need to be a little bit careful not to make this place noisy. The purpose for our meeting, I believe, since April, we've given you the information when the council circulated from the chairman. When we were taking decisions at the council meeting, it happened that your national head, the resident missionary, in the person of Apostle N.A. Amagache, should be transferred from this place to go back to Ghana to take the area leadership of the church in Birikum, in the Bonaf region in Ghana. Since that time, we have been praying and waiting for this day when all of us will meet here to ask God's grace upon his life and also to bid him farewell from this country back to Ghana. So the reason why we are here is to see that our dear pastor and the family are seen off nicely with our prayer support. But don't forget that today is a Sunday, and anytime we meet on Sundays, we give the glory to God, we worship him. So as we are doing all these things, we should also bear in mind that we are before the great King, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. And it is because of him that we are able to do whatever we do. And let us pray together to worship God, and at the same time, see our pastor and the family, our apostle and family, of to the glory of God. Like the national secretary said, we have in our midst the president and the general superintendent of the Indian Pentecostal Church. You are aware, you are here, you know the enormous support that we have been receiving from our brothers from the Indian Church, and especially from the General Superintendent himself. I'm so happy to introduce to you that he is here in our midst. Our dear Reverend John Grass. We also have in our midst Reverend Bruce Hunter. Oh, Reverend John Grass and the wife are together here. So, okay. Reverend Bruce Hunter is one here. Okay. Those of you who were here from the beginning of the program, I mean, since about 2 weeks ago, we saw the chairman of our church here. He was here with us from the beginning through the program that we organized. Unfortunately, some important call had come and he had to leave us. So he's not here with us today, but he just gave us his call, and he's asked us to tell you that though he's not here, his prayers are with us. And as we also hear, we shall also remember him in prayers. So thank God. On this note, I welcome all of you to this important occasion. I believe that the good God who has started with us will bring us to a very successful end. May God bless you.
That's Apostle Dr. S.K. Bedu, the International Missions Director of the Church of Pentecost. We want to acknowledge the presence of Pastor Odriego of Holland and the whole team from Holland. Don't forget Pastor Frank Akwa is from Belgium. And Pastor Benkwe, also from Germany, should take note of that. Amen. Okay, on this note, we are going to enter into a time of praises, and we are asking Reverend Priestley to lead us into a time of praises. Reverend.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. Are you here? Can I see you by your hand, please? Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. We're going to enter into a time of praise. Today is a day of celebration. Do you agree with me? Today is a day of celebration. So why don't we kindly be on our feet as we sing these special songs? These songs have been with us since Apostle was here. And we're going to be singing them to praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Right, shall I see you on your feet, please? Oh,
Thank you. Jesus. Something.
Come on, say what?
Yes, I do, yes, I do. All of that because I want to see my Jesus. The rest of my life, I've made up my mind to go God's way. The rest of my life, in my world, stay no longer with you. My best friend is so sick. Stay no longer with you. I've made up my mind to go God's way. The rest of my life, I've made up my mind. Yeah, listen, this last one.
Can all the parents send our kids upstairs, please? And all the Sunday school teachers, can you go to the Sunday school venue, please? All Sunday school teachers and the parents, please, can you send your kids upstairs? Thank you. Thank you. Please make sure you find a place to sit. Let there be quiet in this place, please. And we're going to ask Deaconess Janet Juma to come forward to come and take the Bible reading for the day.
Praise the Lord. Our scripture reading is taken from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 20, verse 17 to 38. Acts chapter 20, verse 17 to 38. I'm reading from the New International Version of the Bible. The top inscription says, Paul's farewell to the Ephesian elders. From Miletus, Paul sent to Ephesus for the elders of the church. When they arrived, he said to them, you know how I lived the whole time I was with you? From the first day I came into the province of Asia, I served the Lord with great humility and with tears, although I was severely tested by the plots of the Jews. You know that I have not hesitated to preach anything that will be helpful to you, but I have taught you publicly from house to house. I have declared to both Jews and Greeks that they might turn to God in repentance and have faith in the Lord Jesus. And now, compelled by the Spirit, I'm going to Jerusalem, not knowing what will happen to me there. I only know that in every city, the Holy Spirit wants me that prison and hardship are facing me. However, I consider my life worth nothing to me If only I may finish the race and complete the task that the Lord Jesus has given me, the task of testifying to the gospel of God's grace. Now I know that none of you, among whom I have gone about preaching the kingdom, will ever see me again. Therefore, I declare to you today that I am innocent of the blood of all men. For I have not hesitated to proclaim to you the whole will of God. Keep watch over yourselves and all the flock of which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers, the shepherds of the church of God, which he bought with his own blood. I know that after I leave, savage wolves will come in among you and will not spare the flock. Even from your own number men will arise and distort the truth in order to draw away disciples after them. So be on your guard. Remember that for 3 years I never stopped warning each of you night and day with tears. Now I commit you to God and to the word of his grace, which can build you up and give you an inheritance among all those who are sanctified. I have not converted anyone silver or gold or clothing. You yourselves know that these hands of mine have supplied my own needs and the needs of my companions. In everything I did, I showed you that by this kind of hard work, we must help the weak. Remembering the words the Lord Jesus himself said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. When he had said this, he knelt down with all of them and prayed. They all wept as they embraced him and kissed him. What grieved them most was his statement that they would never see his face again. Then they accompanied him to the ship. Amen.
Let's prepare our hearts as we get ready to enter into a time of worship. We shall ask the youth choir to come and just give us a short song ministration as we prepare our hearts to enter into a time of worship. Youth choir.
Hallelujah. Shall we put our hands together for Jesus? Amen.
Somebody give Jesus praise. He's worthy of our glory this morning. Hallelujah.
Oh, Yeah.
You are the most high.
Yeah. shining on. The indescribable God, the inexplicable God. The immutable God, uncompatible God. The immortal, the invisible. All the transcendent God. We want to worship.
Oh, come, let us worship and bow to our King. Let us
is our God. Shall we listen to him? Just wait a moment.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's time for tithes and offerings. We're going to take our tithes and offering. Can we have the offering bowls?
Up
there. Hallelujah. Tithes and offering time is quite a unique time. A time that we honor our God. The Lord says, the Bible says, honor the Lord with our substance and the first fruit of your increase. The Bible also says, it's the Lord that gives us the power, the ability, the anointing, and the favor to make wealth. And he's asking us this hour to test him. with our substance. We've worshipped Him, we've worshipped the Lord, yes. But now is also a time. We are continuing to worship the Lord, but this time with our substance. Could we rise as the music team leads us into bringing our offerings to the Lord?
Hallelujah, so we can pray.
Oh God of grace, oh God of grace, we grow in heart.
So we thank you, Lord, for this.
We lift our heart.
Oh,
We thank you for this time. We thank you for your presence just from the beginning. Praise you for this offering. We are praying that Lord, you bless us. Let your blessing be seen. And let your care be seen as we have gathered today. We thank you for what you are doing in our midst. In Jesus' name, amen.
Sons of God. Sons of God,
march forward.
Sons of God,
march forward.
Victory
through the blood of Jesus.
If you don't go to heaven,
come with Jesus.
Holiness
unto the Lord.
Holiness
unto the Lord.
Men,
the Lord.
Men,
the
men.
Holiness.
Aha, children, are they here? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Youth. We put our hands together for the Lord.
say about him?
I am strong. When I'm weak, I am strong. When I'm weak, I am strong.
Praise God. And when I'm strong, praise God. All right. We're going to sing by the name I'm Pressing On. I'm Pressing On. Those of you who have the program, it will be on the screen anyway. So, good to anyway. Shall we all stand as we take the hymn?
Ah!
from the kingdom of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of light. And he will make sure that we reach higher ground. Amen. We are preparing our hearts to go into the ministry of the Word of God. For now, we want to be able to ask our sister Nana Danso, are you here? Sister Nana Danso, are you here? Just come and give us one solo as we prepare our hearts to go to the ministry of the Word of God.
It has come 3 times, and this is for you. Some time ago, by the gate, the servant of the Lord told the sick man that rupees have I none, but in the name of the Lord, stand up and walk. Daddy, today I speak the same language to you and mommy and the whole family. Rupees have I none, but in the name of the Lord, he will lead you on. Amen. Alpha and Omega, Ashasi Nyerere Nyami, Unim. Azinina, nauna azinina ro, tutu mana mama me, tutu mana mama me, tutu mana mama me o, erasi tutu. Alpha and Omega,
of their meeting on IMD Apostle Dr. S.K. Bedu to take the podium and continue the service.
Apostle Agatha came here
come from my daughter by your temple
with their single purpose.
Well, actually, my uncle,
to preach the gospel
and
to grow the church. And that is why we have many pastors, that is why you are also here. And I thank God that when we look at the work that Apostle has done in this nation, the growth, the extension, the maturity, and many, many good things that if you read the brochure, you see. This has been possible because you prayed for him and supported him. As I was thinking about the message to give, we have a focus as a church. And that is what we are working towards. We are living in a world in which we see many changes. In fact, the world is moving very fast. We are seeing political changes, economic changes, environmental changes. Today you hear tsunami. Technologically, there are so many changes. In fact, people are discovering new truths all the time. But that's one thing I want to say. If you study Christian education, it's a discipline. There's a subject we call Christian education. Just like psychology and what.
So we need education at Timu and in Fabuntio.
And in Christian education, we said that only God has the truth. So there's no truth anywhere. God is truth. So all this technological advancement, things that people are discovering, the new mobile phones and all these things. God had the truth. If he has not revealed the truth, you will never discover it. So these things are indications that God is in control of this world. Before they were able to manufacture aeroplanes, God knew that when they get to know the mechanism, it will fly in the air. But to us, when we see this change, we think new things are happening, but there are truths which are there. And God has got many truths which people will discover. Then we have moral changes. Moral. Now, since that formerly, people were even feeling shy or ashamed. Today, you do it and you'll be praised for doing that. These are changes going on. But to me, though we see these changes, they are not new.
They
only come in diverse ways and in different moods. If you study history, from the very day that God created Adam and Eve,
if you Adam and Eve,
Genesis 3 will tell you that they wanted their liberty. And they were able to accept that liberty. By disobeying God. So what we see in this present age,
it is your
sin increasing. We should not be surprised. Man from the very beginning
has
been humanistic. He wants to be free. He wants to defy what God says. And throughout history, that has been the trend. So what is happening is not new. But thank be to God that we have men whom God used to confront certain issues, to change the trend of
affairs.
And I believe in our time, we need men like that.
Yes,
sir, but
you want
to
come back. Let me know.
So, my
topic
is, where are the Elijahs? Where are the Elijahs? We are reading James chapter 5, verse 16 and 18. I'm reading from the New King James Version. Oh, the NIV, please. It reads, therefore confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so that you may be healed. The prayer of a righteous man is powerful and effective. Verse 17 says, Elijah was a man just like us. He prayed earnestly that it would not rain, and it did not rain on the land for 3.5 years. Again, he prayed, and the heavens gave rain, and the earth produced its crops. Amen.
Kaya Mugu Mano Etinum, Tichamudun Siani Dunson. Monte Kamo from a son church and a homo. Namuni in Paya Mama Homo. Now a Samuare, or you patin and air the Sri, we are day to be a libre. Elia, you only patisan Ara, the bomb paid in this or soon talk. Now see and pass as a soon friend, Yabia, son, and it as Ramasia. Amen.
Elijah was a man like us. Please, when we use the word man, we're talking about human being. He was a human being like you, like me. And he prayed that there should be no rain. And there was no rain. Then he came again and prayed for rain, and there was rain. Why this? Like I said earlier on, see, human nature is said that always he wants to defy the word of God. And it has been the norm. Human beings want their liberty. They want to go against the word of God. And the word of God. Somebody has said that we do what we do because the Greeks did it that way. If you study the history of the Greeks, they were great thinkers. Men like Socrates, Plato.
Plato, who?
Aristotle.
Aristotle.
And they helped a certain group of people, we call them the sophists.
Now, we come here, we can go more and say, actually, for one of our training here, man.
These people came up with so many thoughts.
Now, some professors here, what training here, man, can see,
which we call philosophies.
Ah, your friend will say, one of our training, actually,
our worldviews.
And I said, yeah, man, we are seeing here, man, what tell us what training.
And if you study these worldviews,
that's what training, some of you want.
It has continued through history up to our day.
At once, our So
some of them even thought that there was no God.
People trying to prove that God can't be put down.
Some thought there's God.
This is the only one,
and they believed in other gods.
This is the only one. So what do we want to do? We want to go from.
And some of them thought that man should not rely on any supernatural power, but should use his own wisdom to try to solve his own problems.
We super can say, "No, we can't find home to a body any home. Never offer or money any money answer. Now, me man, I want home. When I can say it to
so we have passed through so many things.
It took us a year see after some of them.
When we came to medieval age,
now the back of the sofa, a year see a chair we call it now and be my answer. So
Christianity came,
Christosum Abba,
and Roman Catholicism became the strongest.
Yeah, who said Roma
They also followed the intellectual beliefs of the Greeks.
Now also Greek before Asia.
So humanistic ideas have been throwing, have been challenging us all the time.
And don't you know when I'm moving put your banner and only Yama could you
and
learn now.
And in our modern day,
then for some previous evening.
We have what we call the postmodern world.
Your near fellow said, "We are here, a chum. About we are here,
postmodern.
A two pound, a cross what I say.
What?
And if the entrance won, and if the entrance won, I can't even get the best match now, Masia. But I don't
know. You see, all that I want to say is that,
and the best out here is here.
We live in a changing world.
Yeah, well, we are here, down, 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 down.
But we have unchanging world. Unchanging truth.
And then the problems are ancestors.
So no matter the changes going on,
it is only ancestors.
We have the unchanging truth.
Yeah, well, somewhere in the ancestors.
Nowadays,
what's happening?
Some people even think that there's no authentic truth.
The people who say, I am a quality.
They'll tell you that, oh, every religion will take you to
God. So,
Christianity,
Jesus,
any other religion.
They
are equating Christianity to any other religion. People should not judge people for what they do.
And then this one show me now time when
if I don't want to put on any some type of dress,
and then this one get myself the pop trip and I'm going to get the
pack. That's what I want to do.
No matter what you have,
keep quiet.
It was all wrong.
So if you criticize me,
that is a whole cousin to have.
You are rather committing a crime.
That is a whole woman and I was move from.
People are thinking about human rights.
And don't you know, Nipa will be so now to you, Nipa will find out here.
Last time we were at the Ariam Stress, when one of our brothers came and he gave us a very long book with human rights laws. Don't do this, you do this, the government will hold you. And if you go through all this, I'm afraid you have nothing to even do. And you don't even have the border to be because the human rights, you abuse it, and when you abuse it, you get arrested.
Now, only our years of confusion and a black jail body will be by a church and near my church, and you wait also your way when you miss all yet. Now, if you are making this and even a little bit of being off in a young person, you must have yet to be yet, and you have to be done by this.
Now, no respect for authority.
Sometimes when you are
talking about these things, you think it's very far. But even in the church, sometimes people don't want to go under authority.
So you can't even have this over children who are never so cry about it. They want to offend the inner
and through our televisions and other mass media, we are being influenced daily by this postmodernism worldview.
And when you have television show, after you have a contract, you have a new one. Who said, people have been known that before whom man, they were the one man, we are so front in the man.
You may not see, but you are being changed even into a Christian. This worldview is changing you gradually.
We have our right. Oh, whether
was
the
and even if somebody commits a sin,
it be a one
and you want to suspend a person,
that's all person who to say,
then he'll tell you,
no,
Pastor,
so for
I have my right. This is the world in which we live.
Where we are here,
is it? Now, men don't want to marry women.
I don't remember so. A better name comes of a worry over her.
And women don't want to marry men.
And a man's true person worry men.
Even fish. Fishes in the sea. Good. They don't do that. But human beings are rich.
Everybody has to say, I want to grab my name, but you know, I want to grab my name, sir. They will nip up the person who was happening.
In fact, nowadays, people are determined, they don't want to hear anything of God.
And human beings are trying
to elevate themselves above God.
And the people of man who come and check with their couple.
Like I told you, why did Adam disobey God?
So let me tell you, Adam or Tina who was with you.
The devil told Adam,
on Sabbath, the same.
And if.
God says you should not eat this food.
Oh, God is lying. He told you if you eat it, you die. You will not die. You will be like God. So the underlying sin is man or human being trying to become like God. And that is why we have all these things. God says, man should marry a woman, and man is saying no, man to man.
When you say, what is that? That's not a better man, a war of man. That's only possible, that's not a better man, a war of a better man.
This is the world in which we are living.
When do we ask you, and you are a man of your team?
But the question is,
never say, we said,
is this the first time that we are seeing these things,
and as a woman, I'm going to declare here who's an Emea man.
The names given to the period are penned by men who do some research and they say that this time is called modern time, tomorrow will be postmodernism. Even now, we are saying Generation X, and another name will come very soon. Men using their own intellectual abilities are given a stage. Now let me tell you, the human nature is the same.
Hallelujah. And if you remember that translation, we said, and when we are alone, no one does not want to be able to be at the other side. I don't know the purpose of it, it was free, and we were going to be able to ask the translation, we didn't want to be able to say, we don't want to be able to
do that. You see, when we talk about homosexuality,
then we are going to say, I saw a band, a band, a band, a band, a band, a
band. It's not a postmodern idea.
And that idea is happening in the world.
You go to the Bible, Sodom and Gomorrah.
Sodom and Gomorrah.
You know it. So what is new?
And today I have a from my.
You come to Romans 1. There's 18 going. Paul was so hard.
Not Paul, the mere break
power. That men,
some merry man,
were having passion for men.
Now our common, that man in the mere man.
Because they refused to obey what God was saying.
Now, they
disregarded God.
Now, actually,
and the Bible says God gave them up.
Now, the Bible says to me, I just had one man.
My point is,
now the pastor is telling us
what we see today.
The young woman and never able.
It's not new.
I got there. I have a program.
Since Sodom and Gomorrah said,
if you Sodom and Gomorrah, I'm able.
If you come to the New Testament,
so what about you from one?
I will humbly ask us to read 2 Timothy 3.
Timothy 1, it doesn't mean you to be a son.
Paul says, I'm reading from the NIV. from verse 1, the NIV statement. From the NIV. But mark this, there will be terrible times in the last days. People will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boastful, proud. The lady with the cheese sugar, I want you to get a stamp in the ground.
Timothy, what does me know? It means a more edicain or elbow. And when you say an idea, Chilemuno, a mere Muya de Baba, Fiso de Papa Yako Perfor, Sika Perfor, a Huwa Waffor, a Hantan for, a Bususanka for, our first and most for Dim for, Bunia for, one of the better way Timao, one of Winnie Dog, Pamsa for, Missacuba for. One I want you to come to one I want you to one I want papa, I fetch a four, and your team four, one I want grind, one I want to need GTS, no, your coupon. Okay, can you want to change your son back? Now, so what people are going to do? Send me, that will do if you want. Amen.
So, this is Paul being, you know, having foresight. And having the revelation of God, writing this down for us. Now, when the last days,
Paul, the
people will be lovers of themselves. So, when this is happening, if you go outside the church,
you
don't want to be free. They think of themselves more than any other thing. So, this is my right. This is my right. And sometimes, even in the church, people want to fight for themselves. And love of money.
Those
too proud,
dancing,
disobedient to parents, ungrateful. So Paul saw these
things
and forewarned us. Treacherous people, people who are rash,
conceited,
lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God. And that is the temperature.
We
see it everywhere. And he continues saying that in verse 4, chapter 4. And he says, in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, 1 Timothy, 2 Timothy chapter 4. In the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead? And in view of his appearing and his kingdom, I give you this charge. Preach the word. Be prepared in season and out of season. Correct, rebuke, and encourage. But let's come to the verse 4. For the time will come when men will not put up with sound doctrine. You can read the verse
4 again.
Verse 3.
Emu mensa na ebre bi ebaba won tie chire chire pa aye no na enam se won osu aye won hin nti obesoa achire chire fo aboaso se de won ala akomotie no be won so afri no kure ho na wadane akotie anasesem. Amen.
For the time will come when men will not put up with sound doctrine. Instead, to suit their own desires, they will gather around them a great number of teachers to say what their itching ears want to hear. They will turn their ears away from the truth and turn aside to myth. But you, keep your head in all situations. But you,
now so what dear,
keep your head in all situations.
So
the point here is that these things are there, people are taking to all this life because they want to disobey God. The temptation is that Christians are quiet. We don't want to offend anybody, so we keep quiet. And gradually, these people are rather converting the Christians.
Now,
Church leaders are quiet.
So when you fall, I dee.
And whatever comes,
you have a piano.
Hey,
I tell you.
We want to become gentle.
Yeah, pay what's up
in our seats.
Our younger seats.
So long as we get food to eat.
See, let me be deep, let me be no more there.
Whatever happens to the gospel,
you bet two.
And to Christianity, people are quiet. But today,
they want to know.
Apostle Magacha came here to preach the gospel. The focus is that the gospel should be preached. And we need people who will preach the gospel. Who will confront the issues at this time. That is why I was asking the question, where are the Elijahs?
And not only we say, as we are saying, Elijah for no
boy. You see, Elisha asked a question.
Elisha.
He asked a question. Where is the God of Elijah?
Was it Oyangobo, Elijah, Yangobo, or him?
Then he took his mantle.
How long father look so? And on the bomb.
And immediately the water parted.
And I thought that you
and the answer was that God of Elijah is still on the throne. But when we
asked
the question,
Elijah.
And James was telling us that Elijah was a man just like us.
And I was saying, James, you can say, Elijah, not what you said in the world.
And he was able to stand.
Never want to be chinan.
To face the world view of the day.
And to be the piercing year one, the pitcher one, and to be chinan.
With the unchanging truth.
And to be chinan, as someone which we know.
Of the word of God.
Ah, are you in the piercing also?
Where are the Elijahs?
Elijah, the one over here, amen.
Now, you read 2 Kings.
Okay, kind.
And Elijah is just introduced abruptly.
Him who went out just you know how you say when he and our dad Elijah did
we don't open. They don't tell us his lineage.
Well, I can't tell you. They
only told that he's from Tishbe.
You know we are also can't say from Tishbe.
And a prophet of God.
And we are going to be before.
And all that we saw that he was before King Ahab.
That the who we are not just about to say we didn't or hit him Ahab.
Tell
her that I will say
there will be no rain.
Ensure, I will ensure
now. Tell her,
this is me.
Speak.
I can say to them.
I pray that God will give them the grace.
We pump that so that they can have a double one. Amen.
Amen. Apostle Magacha is going.
Yes, go for Magacha or go.
But the focus of the church is still there.
They will not show no people time there or hold
that. We have to preach the gospel.
I will say, can you hear?
In season and out of season, we need to stand up.
I was saying to be sorry, you know,
like Elijah.
Just like Elijah,
who knew what to do.
I know, but knew the also way.
Like the sons of Issachar.
Just Issachar and Manasseh.
They knew the times.
No one knew the
and they took the right action.
I don't know why. Yeah, near man, like a sense of something.
Even with the life of Elijah,
even Elijah could have been a problem.
If you read through,
so he got a better support.
Sometimes God told him.
Go and hide. Then at
that time,
go and
reveal yourself.
So we should
know when to keep quiet.
And when to rise
up.
And preach
the gospel. If we continue to be quiet,
so you are planning to be
one minute to speak.
I was here to be cancer.
Things will change.
And near my never ever.
And I believe as a church. And as leaders, we need to rise up.
I was saying sorry.
Can and hear from God. You know, Elijah didn't just go and stand before the king. Because of his academic qualifications, I'm Professor Elijah.
Dr. Elijah.
It's good to be steady. But we need men. And women. Who will be close to God and hear from God. So when they speak, God will back
them
up. In this postmodern
world,
the situation was just like our time. Things
are
gone wrong.
Anybody in this city,
the people of God were not worshiping God. They have not left the word of God and worshiping
back
and claiming many things for themselves. There's no God. Let us use our human
life.
But there was Elijah.
Amen.
There was not Elijah. I believe the ministry of Apostle Magache has produced more Elijahs.
Amen.
Amen.
And as he is living, he has left Elijahs here.
Amen.
Who can stand and support the Apostle coming?
Now we are
together. Elijah was a man of prayer. He waited upon God. He heard from God. So whenever he came, he had the boldness to speak the man of God. You see, God will confirm the word of God. His people,
His
servants. We need to arise. Elijah was a man just like us. He had his weaknesses, but God used him. I believe that God will use us. And we need more of
Elijah.
What is the God of Elijah? He is on the throne. David went to the battleground. And Saul was hiding. Instead of preaching the word of God, he was preaching that who can fight? If he fights, and he kills
Goliath,
I will give him my daughter. I will do this. I will do that.
May you see him? May you see him?
And he had no boldness to fight. Why? Because he had no conviction even in the gospel. Brethren, if we hold on to the gospel,
as
the only unchanging truth,
as
the only power of salvation, and power to heal, we will preach the gospel, and God will let sense accompany our
response.
Church members, we should arise. When we talk of Church of Pentecost, it wasn't only the pastors and apostles who did the job. We were told that when we receive the Holy Spirit and we are baptized in the Holy Spirit, you receive power. And sense will follow you. It's not a matter of being a pastor,
no.
A young man who has got the heart of Elijah, wanted to change the situation so that God will be
glorified.
We need men like that. We need good men like that. And members of the church were moved by the Holy Spirit. But the young men.
Yes, you know, right here was
who are from the Holy Spirit.
Move
throughout the whole
country.
Went to villages. Preach the gospel. And the church spread. The power of the Holy Spirit was working in the individuals. Brethren, we need to take this land for Jesus
Christ.
And all church leaders should come together so that we will stand and confront issues. Otherwise, there will be a time. There will be some laws that maybe we should not worship. We need men and women who will go cross
to God.
Who will take the gospel and accept the gospel? Stand on the gospel as the only means of salvation. And there's no other name. And I want to repeat it. There's no other name. Amongst men, except only one
Jesus.
Will you mention the name for me?
Jesus.
We need to arrest.
I was here, sorry.
You like Elijah?
Not yet to say Elijah.
Elijah comforted the issue.
And you know, never
Elijah was prayerful. Never you
be a one
and you were tactful.
After you know, you be able to me.
He had a skillful hand.
Never will be able to be to
he knew what to do. If you are going straight,
it is so I know to
another
to
if you have done that,
said go yes,
I believe Ahab might have caused some people to arrest him.
He didn't say I have maybe a him.
And whatever that had happened to him should have happened to him.
Now if you had to get to
but he just went in.
And so sort of
because he heard from God.
Now
and said, please, I'm going to speak.
Also,
there will be no rain. And when he said that, he ran away.
Okay.
Until the king and the people suffered. God's hand was upon
Elijah.
From there, he directed him to some place. Fed him. And when the brook crashed, when there was no water, he was directed to the widow.
But
if you stand for God, God will care for you.
Amen.
He will provide you.
Amen.
He will never disappoint you. Until God spoke to him,
that
go back. And the king was yearning to see him.
Now I hear no Akuma Prince of
so when he saw him,
that you know,
he said, hey, you
was a whoop.
You are the troubler.
What is that? That was shooting with you.
Said, and now it's not
trouble.
But the trouble is with you.
Never trouble with me.
Then he had the opportunity.
And when you're something
to tell him all the wrong things going on. May God give them the strategy. May God give them the grace. So that we will be able to know what to do. To confront issues of our day. Elijah did it.
Elijah also. Oh yeah.
We need people like Elijah.
Yeah, hear the people say Elijah.
Who will not be afraid?
I also.
Even to die. So that Christianity will stand.
So that we are Christian. So
many things are going on.
Everyone have also.
And where are the Elijahs?
Now Elijah follow him.
You see, people like Paul. They all stood up.
Why did I that?
Because of the gospel.
And
Paul went to the same to say that if anybody preaches another gospel,
one
person should be cursed.
So the bigger,
so they knew.
And you know that
the gospel has no power to save.
Sir, Namia Samu now to be sent to jail.
Brothers, all that I want to say is that the gospel is powerful.
Namia Samu now to be.
Unchanging truth.
And
God's means of salvation. And they can turn the hearts of our modern day people. When we get the right strategy, when we get to know God's voice, the one I said confrontation, I'm not saying we should go and fight. when I was writing my thesis, I was saying that even in Ghana, we don't have proper Christian schools. Because the government controls the education system. But in Ghana, we are told the Christians are 75% of the nation. So Christians should come together and have a say. So that we can change the trend. We sit down on consent. Things will change. God will not come from heaven. I was discussing this with somebody. And he said, oh, God will bring another revival. But how do you expect a revival? Unless we get people like Elijah. Who pray as have the desire to love God.
Now what do you mean?
To see to them God's name is glorified.
Now what continue.
So as I the apostolates, I believe he has really preached the gospel.
What can you hear?
I know him very well. I stayed together with him in
Gambia.
We moved through the length and breadth of that nation. Going through the villages. Sometimes sleeping places where we never didn't want to sleep. Just to preach the gospel. And I believe you have done the same job here.
Jesus was to our house here.
But as he lives, we need Elijah to follow
him.
So that the nation and even the church.
You
see, there are some people they are in the church, all that they do is that, oh, for me, I speak the truth.
The only people who are the way I say, maybe they cannot grow.
What truth is he talking about?
I don't know.
You go into it and you see that it is all selfishness. So what he thinks is truth, that's all.
It is not
truth. Maybe he will not ask why this or that.
Oh, some sudden he say,
then he start going up.
No, so
you see what is happening in the church? They are spreading the church. For me,
you
must
speak
the truth.
Maybe you might come up with
it. And somebody will even say that, oh, for me, for so many years, the pastor doesn't like me. He has never asked me to preach before.
For me, so many years,
I'm happy he's going.
But you
know
what is
coming? You know
what is coming?
Maybe he will let me preach.
I don't know what I'm doing.
And what did he say? Is the four walls of this room the evangelical church?
Hello, maybe that's an answer. I'm not a church here. Hello, I'm not a church here.
No,
maybe
in the early church,
I saw brothers here.
The members moved.
Was saying I saw a man
with the gospel.
I could call.
Preaching the gospel.
I could call your name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And they were able to take the gospel to Antioch.
So what did you say about Antioch?
To Samaria.
That was Samaria.
And we have to hold the gospel truth.
Now, what did you say about Antioch?
And preach the gospel.
What kind of gospel?
Support the gospel.
And we appoint the
gospel. So that together,
so
that
we are Yemma,
we can confront the issues of the day.
Yemma,
I pray that as our apostles in Ghana too, they need the gospel. In Brekum area, they need the gospel. You see, the gospel is needed everywhere. In Ghana, we haven't finished reaching the unreached. You go to some part of Ghana, you will not find any church there. But thanks be to God. In every village, the remotest area, you see a Pentecost pastor working on the gospel. All the big, big names you hear, they will never go to the villages.
But
go to the cottages. You will meet Elijah there. Where are the Elijahs?
Elijah,
and support the work of God.
That was
one point of
the
answer. May God bless us.
God bless you.
Can we be on our feet at this time? Lord, lift me up and let me stand by faith on earth. This terrible land where love and joy and alcohol love upon my feet on earth. We don't want to stand as Christians and face issues of today. Now God is challenging you. And He is telling you that Elijah was a man just like you. So there is no difference between you and Elijah. So if Elijah was able to change the affairs of his time, God has the power and authority in you to change the situation of today. So the power to change the world is in your hands. We are praying that God make me an Elijah of my time. Let me rebuke the situation. And let your grace reign in the world.
Now, someone Christ wants to be the king in the world.
Most especially, God reign in London.
And I am posing that we be the king in our London.
And all the cities in England.
Now, I am a great king.
God make me an instrument of blessing. Shall we pray at this time and lift our hands to mighty God?
Oh, Heavenly Father,
Father, we pray to you. Oh, God, the Lord, you give us the strength. You give us the power. You give us the joy. You give us the boldness, Jesus Christ. Lord, we have been able, Lord, and we are too much afraid to fight against the issues of today. We pray, Father God, let your mighty hand, God, come upon us. Take away all the fears. Lord, take away. Lord Jesus Christ, you remove all God, the cross of the night.
Thank you. Father. Thank you, God, for your love for us today and for reminding us, God, of your word. The world, God, may change. Many different things with different names will come. But you remain an unchanging God. We give you all praise, glory, and honor for, Lord, encouraging us today. For us to know what you have made us. That even though, Lord, we are human beings, we carry your power and your spirit. And whatever we believe, without any doubt, when we pray for, Lord, will come to pass. We know the world today, the manifold things, God, that are going around us. And even sometimes some of such things which must not be mentioned among Christians coming in our midst. Today, Father, we stand in the Spirit of the Lord Jesus Christ and condemn such acts. The acts of homosexualism, lesbianism, and all the filthy acts, Lord Jesus, that are even penetrating, God, into churches. Whereby even ministers, Lord, are even identifying themselves with such evil acts. We come against them today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We will never turn less as spirits.
Jesus.
Lord, in the church of Pentecost.
Yes, Lord.
Worldwide and especially in the UK. And therefore, Lord, we pray that if any of our members,
Jesus,
have been entangled with this act,
Jesus,
today as your word has come forth,
oh yes,
Father, we unbow them,
Jesus,
and set them free.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We believe that, God, this act is from the devil.
Oh yes.
If it is not from the devil, you wouldn't say that those who do certain things,
yes,
will inherit everlasting damnation.
Yes.
Because it is your will that all people gathered here are going to be saved.
Yes, Lord.
But it is the devil who comes in to steal, to kill, and to destroy.
Yeah.
But today, if there is somebody here,
yes, Lord.
Lord Jesus, that's in that situation,
Jesus,
we set that person free.
Amen.
Lord, by the power that has been invested in us,
Jesus,
in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
And then, Father God, we pray,
Jesus,
that your spirit will come upon your people.
Oh, yes.
That even as we leave this service,
oh, yes, Lord,
and God enter into our individual homes,
oh, God,
our workplaces, Lord, the public environment,
yes,
we pray that your word will never depart from our lips.
Oh, God.
We will preach it in season and out of season.
Yes.
So God, grant us boldness.
Amen.
Take away every fear from us.
Jesus.
And my prayer, the Lord, even us they obey.
Yes, Lord.
And speak your word abroad.
Oh, God.
May miracles, signs, and wonders,
yes,
Lord, follow the administration.
Amen.
May it be so in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are a living God, Father.
Thank you.
We also want to thank you, God, for what our dear apostle and the family have planted in their midst.
Amen.
Even as they are living, we know the hard times will come.
Amen.
May we never forget the administration, but may we always visit, God, your word.
Amen.
Which you have given to us through them to confront any unforeseeable things that comes away. So that if they hear about the church in the UK, they'll always raise their hands and give you the glory.
Yes.
Now to the speaker, what he has given us, we pray the Lord you give him back. In abundance.
Amen.
That anytime he stands,
yeah,
rivers of living water will be flowing through him.
Yes,
we are so grateful to you because you are a loving Jesus.
Amen.
In your precious name we pray with thanksgiving. And let the people of God say a big amen.
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 Shall we bless Apostle Dr. Pedro for the message?
We are going to have one solo and then very quickly, very, very soon, we'll move into the main, the part two of the service. Sister Adelaide, also are free. Are you here? Just one solo, please. Just one solo.
Onyamisumu, Mwadimba, Akamusai, Onyini.